Hello student, how are you? Strength of organic acids and bases that we already started, and there we have seen the strength of organic acids and bases. There are the three theories we already learned. One is the Arrhenius theory, second one is the Lorentz-Bronsted theory, and third one is the Lewis theory. These are the three theories we have seen in detail. Today we are going to learn very important concept, that is the strength of acids. First one is the strength of acids. Strength of acids, that is pKa value. pKa values. pKa value, you might be knowing that pKa is not that Salman Khan's pKa, but it is a pKa. Stand for that measuring. It is a measurement of the acidity, whether it is a strong or weak, that we are going to find out by knowing the pKa values. But for determining or measuring the pKa value, let us consider any general acid. Consider any acid HA which is dissociated in water, and let us see, as HA is acid plus water H2O at an equilibrium, how that acid HA acid get dissociated. Here the H3O plus and A minus. This is a conjugate acid base theory according to as a Lorentz-Bronsted theory, that things that reactions are occurring. What we have did here, consider any acid HA which is dissociated in water, it produces this one. And according to as a law of mass action, or what we can call it as a equilibrium constant, what do you get here? We know that at an equilibrium constant, we can write this equation, the concentration of the product divided by concentration of the reactor. So the K is equal to concentration of hydronium ion into concentration of A minus divided by concentration of HA acid into concentration of water, right? K stand for dissociation constant for acid, where Ka stands for dissociation constant for acid. That K stands for dissociation constant for acid. Now, water is always taken in a large excess, as H2O is in large excess. So, we can take it as a constant, large excess. It is a constant, and therefore, we will get here K is equal to H3O plus concentration of hydronium ion into concentration of A minus divided by concentration of HA acid into here we can call it as a K equilibrium, and therefore here you can call it as a K dash, where K dash is for water, new constant, and therefore we can there is a K equilibrium, and we can bring this K dash to this side, it will become K इक्विलिब्रियम इनटू के डैश इज इक्वल टू के ए वेर के इज अ न्यू कॉन्स्टेंट वेर के इज अ न्यू कॉन्स्टेंट हियर इज अ न्यू कॉन्स्टेंट एंड वी विल बी गेटिंग हियर द फाइनल एक्सप्रेशन और फाइनल इक्वेशन दिस के ए इज इक्वल टू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ H3O प्लस इंटू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ए माइनस डिवाइडेड बाय कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ Hc. दिस इज अ इक्वेशन नंबर वी कैन गिव एनी दिस इज अ इक्वेशन व्हाट वी गॉट हियर एंड फ्रॉम दिस के वेर के स्टैंड फॉर द डिसोसिएशन कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर एसिड. Now, from this equation, if the concentration of this hydronium ion A minus increases, K will increases, dissociation will increases, hence the acidity goes on increasing. But here, the Ka value is, always in the power, negative power of the 10, and that's why K is always expressed in terms of pKa, and therefore pKa pKa is we know that pKa is equal to minus log to the base 10 Ka. This is the new values we are getting. pKa value means for avoiding the negative power of 10, we have converted this K value into pK, and pK definition of pK is nothing but as a minus logarithm to the base 10 K. As pK value decreases, the acid strength goes on increasing, and that is the main reason why pK value. Let us see here one where K increases acidity goes on increasing, hence pK value decreases. In short, you must remember is a pK value is a smaller pK value decreases, acidity increases. That you have to remember in your while explaining the pK value of this. Let us see another point here. The strength of bases means pKb values. Now, second point we are going to learn here is strength of pKb values. The second point, the strength of bases, that is pKb value, that we are going to do. Just now we have seen strength of acids pKa values, so similarly the strength of bases. Now consider the base, consider the base B dissociate in water or dissolve in water. What it produce? Here is a base plus H2O at an equilibrium, it produce BH plus into OH minus. Any base which is dissolved in water produces as OH minus. So according to equilibrium constant, so K equilibrium is equal to concentration of BH plus into concentration of OH minus divided by concentration of B into concentration of water. As we know that water is H2O is taken in constant, taken as large excess, so that we will get K equilibrium is equal to B एच प्लस इनटू OH माइनस डिवाइडेड बाय कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ बी इनटू के डैश, वेयर यू हैव टू रीअरेंज दिस इक्वेशन. आफ्टर रीअरेंजिंग दिस इक्वेशन व्हाट डू यू गेट? यू विल गेट के इक्विलिब्रियम इनटू के डैश इज इक्वल टू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ बी एच प्लस इनटू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ OH minus divided by base, and where that into K, K equilibrium into K dash is a taken as a K is a new constant, and the above equation becomes K as above equation becomes KB is equal to concentration of BH plus into concentration of OH minus divided by B, where KB is equal to dissociation constant for base. KB stand for base, B stand for base. So KB is equal to dissociation constant for base. So now here KB is always coming in the negative power of the 10, and to simplify this KB in terms of PK value, so we know that PKB is equal to minus log to the base 10 KB, and where that when the KB increases, the basicity also goes on increasing. Is PKB is PKB value increases, the base value also decreases, and therefore as we know that by combining this both PKA plus PKB is nothing but as a 4P. This is a new equation, as you know that. If suppose let us see as a PK is PK PKB is given 2.5, right? Then we can easily calculate by using this formula. So PKA is equal to PKA plus 2.5 is equal to 14, so PKA is equal to 11.5 something, right? 11 point something. So that is the, in this way we can calculate PK value of this. So we have learned about this, how to these are the some, this is not what we can call it as a this type of the expression is not going to ask in exam, but for knowledge point of view, the how it is calculated, how it is derived, that you should know. That's why I am giving the detail. I am taking each and every point from the syllabus, so and in the easiest way you can understand. So if you listen carefully, you can understand these things are very very easily, and you can refer this Manali publication as a I am suggesting you should make your own handwriting notes, so that you can quickly understand, you can acquire the good knowledge. So let us stop today here. Remaining we will see the next lecture. Thank you.